So I'm joined here today by Peter Lytle, who's you're going to be our new Brighton Hove Albion analyst.
I hope so.
And you've been a fan for how long? A number of years?
About 50-odd years.
It's a long time, so there's a lot of expertise there. You were there also on Friday against Valencia.
I was.
So how did that go? Obviously, we started... good start, 2-1.
Impressive. First part of the game, we were pushed back by Valencia, who are a very good side.
I mean, who are in the Champions League again.
Champions League, yep. Top four.
Yeah.
But we gradually got into the game, and second half, I thought that we were the better side. I think he may have tinkered a little bit at half-time, Potter the manager, and we seemed to be a bit more on the front foot. So encouraging, and nice to see Duffy on the score sheet again with a very powerful header.
Yes, so. And Trossard, you're saying he was good. Trossard, Eden Hazard.
Definitely glimpses of Eden Hazard.
Yeah.
Within the first 5 minutes, he was turning and twisting, and he's got a low centre of gravity like Hazard. I think the crowd are going to like him. I think he's going to be impressive.
Yeah, I mean, we've had that before, haven't we, with players. They kind of get... You get glimpses of genius, and then doesn't quite turn out that way for the whole season.
Yes, well, it's a tough league, the Premiership, and of course we've got a history, haven't we, with signing players from the Belgian and the Dutch league, and not really coming off and scoring the goals that they score in those leagues.
Yes. Yeah.
But I think he's going to be more than goals. I think he's going to be assists, and he's going to create some free kicks around the edge of the box.
Yeah.
So I think he's exciting. I think he's exciting.
Because I think we struggled to score goals, particularly the second half of last season. So we're looking for that supply. And you're saying that Trossard could be someone that could be the man to...
Definitely.
To do that.
And additionally, I think what I saw against Valencia was that the team as a whole were pressing up from the back as a unit. Whereas last year, there was much more of this separation. And there was Glenn Murray on his own up front.
Yes.
What seemed to me on Friday was that there was more of a combined attack, so there weren't those big gaps in the midfield. So
yeah.
I think that provided we can get some crosses into Murray, he'll finish the chances.
Yeah, he's at the age of 35, so he'll be the key target man. We might get in, is it Depay from Brentford for 20 minutes? Looks like he's going to be joining the squad.
Looks as though he's going to be joining. He's obviously a proven goal scorer in the Championship. He got 28 goals last year.
Yeah.
But apparently other clubs are after him as well. So I think if we get him, that'll be a very good investment because we need somebody that can really put the ball in the back of the net.
Yes, so Lacadia and Adone are going to get another chance this season, aren't they? So they really need to step up to the plate. Oh, Adone did well in some games, didn't he?
He did.
And Lacadia, he did well towards the end of the season. But as you say, we were really struggling for goals, which is a bit of an understatement, but let's be... Yes. Positive. So we need to. We just can't rely on Glenn Murray, can we?
No.
His 13 goals.
No. Lacadia. I think the jury's still out on Lacadia.
Yeah.
He started quite well on Friday, but then he seems to be lacking confidence to me.
Yes.
Maybe he needs a few goals, but I'm not certain that he's going to get the chance to provide those goals.
Yes. But maybe Trossard could be the person that's... Because he'd be good at... He's an aerial threat. He could be the person that supplies him with the balls into the box to...
Yeah. He's great with the crosses, Trossard. And also what's nice is he changes wings. So he switches and one minute he's on the left, next he's on the right, and then he's just behind the front, you know, the front four.
Yes.
So, yeah, and he delivers a wicked dead ball. So
yeah.
I think we've got to hope that will bring something.
In defence, we're not sure about Dunk. It's a bit of a question mark over him, whether or not he goes to Leicester City or another club. We've brought in a new defender as well, haven't we, from Bristol City.
We have.
And then the one we got from Portsmouth, Matt Clark, he's now been loaned out. So there's been a lot of movement in defence.
Yes, there has. I mean, I think probably Potter has taken the view that Matt Clark is perhaps not quite right for the Premiership.
Yeah.
Because he was in the first with Portsmouth, so he's now gone out to Derby, where he'll get some good playing time.
Yeah.
Webster, they've just signed for £20 million from Bristol City. They must rate him to spend £20 million on a defender.
Yes.
The question is Dunk going to Leicester, as you hinted at? There's a suggestion they might be going for £40 million. Or why have we bought a £20 million defender from Bristol City? We've got a few days to find out, haven't
yes.
we?
Yes, yeah, we have. So let's make some predictions.
We ought to be getting some points
yes.
there.
Yes, yeah.
But it's going to be a tough year, I think. It's no question. We don't know much about the manager, Potter. He's a bit of an unknown quantity in the Premiership. The bookies have us fourth favourites to go down.
Yes.
At 2-1.
With the three go down, so that's
three
promising.
Go down, so that's promising.
Yes.
They're saying Norwich Sheffield United. And Burnley, which surprises me.
Yes.
Because I think Dyche is a very good manager and he'll probably keep them afloat. But I think, like you perhaps, Newcastle might be the other team that are in danger.
So thanks for coming in, Peter.
Pleasure.
And we'll catch up again soon.
Okay. Thanks, Mark.